can fix this.
That'll hold. Learn something new every day. Another bounty. Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? Always need this.
Boozman, are you listening? You're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper.
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A NERO chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. And don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
What do we got?
Whoa, hold on, hold on. They're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
See me, I'm dead. Throw a rock, that'll distract them. You hear that? That's right, go check it out.
Now, can't we?
Okay, that ought to distract them.
much longer do you think we got?
How the hell do I know? We'll bug out when the dock's finished.
Okay, stay low, stay low.
I'm getting sick.
After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, it's Orion. Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
But they're sleeping like bitches. And I asked if you were going in. Say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors of the White King Hunt.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Secret caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Yeah. Getting hungry?
I'm young.
We got enough fuel to get back. Going all over hell and back today.
Fuel is the least of our problems when we're on the ground. Just let me stay.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode on a farewell, the NERO guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
You just listen. I heard them over the radio. Talking about a man named O'Brien.
Think, don't.
Not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Get some sleep. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell is now our life. Came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. Spoke out against the feds? Well, thanks to those who are fine. Cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know. Because they came
to
me. I
guess I'd come back here if it had burning this infestation.
I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.
Sniper on the road. Oh, goddammit.
Finally. Jesus. Power's off. Figures. Do I get in? Guess not. Way onto the roof. Scrap. Good old NERO death trains. Yeah, that was a real good idea, digging mass graves and hauling all these corpses out here.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth is a gift for us all, to use as we see fit, to provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We want
on to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Thing is, Cope, fuel prices have come down lately. Way down. Only problem is you gotta find it yourself. And last I checked...
You there? Boozman, come back.
Deacon, hey, I'm here.
I'm going on a the NERO guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell that was, who took Sarah.
What are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
Out here, there ain't nothing but murderers and drifters and raiders.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free.
The hell?
The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I...
Men, cover! Cover!
Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. Because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last week's defense fell. Broadcast. Moving from town to town. And the days before the roads came choked with cars and the...
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode out of Farewell, the NERO guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know. Because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.
Oh, good. Scrap. Okay. Okay. Way onto the roof. Off figures. Locked. Mass grave. What, they'd bury this shit out here again? Oh, yeah, because they're assholes.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth is a gift for us all, to use as we see fit, to provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now if the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Here is Cope. Fuel prices have come down, baby. Only problem is you gotta find yourself. And last I checked, there were plenty of assholes out here trying to take what's rightfully ours.
Thank you.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey.
We rode out of farewell. The NERO guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Hey, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
There. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen. I heard on the radio talking about a man named O'Brien.
Meek, don't.
Not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they'd have blown it to hell. Just way onto the roof. Okay, let me guess. Out of fuel. Yeah, of course. Thank you. injector. Let's see if it still works. Better living through chemistry. Oh, another one of those micro recorders.
Sir, yeah, we got a problem.
We got a lot of problems, soldier. Which one are you talking about?
We got another train coming in hot.
Get those people to move back. Move back. Radio command, we got no more room. I told them we need another dozen backhoes out here, or we gotta shut this site down.
Sir, you don't understand.
The hell I don't. Those assholes in Portland just don't listen. I tell them we got no more room out here. We got traffic backed up all the way to Farewell.
Every
cot from here to Chabot is full of people bleeding out of their goddamn eyes.
Train! No one's answering.
What the hell are you talking
radio,
about?
Radio, no one's goddamn answering.
Move!
Hey! Move out
trying to reclaim shit. You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy.
Yeah.